Acapulco de Juárez, commonly called Acapulco, is a city, municipality and major seaport in the state of Guerrero on the Pacific coast of Mexico, 380 kilometers south of Mexico City. Acapulco is located on a deep, semicircular bay and has been a port since the early colonial period of Mexico's history. It is a port of call for shipping and cruise lines running between Panama and San Francisco, California, United States. The city of Acapulco is the largest in the state, far larger than the state capital Chilpancingo. Acapulco is also Mexico's largest beach and balneario resort city. The city is one of Mexico's oldest beach resorts, which came into prominence in the 1940s through 1960s as a getaway for Hollywood stars and millionaires. Acapulco is still famous and still attracts many tourists, although most are now from Mexico itself. Acapulco's gastronomy is very rich. The following are typical dishes from the region. Relleno is baked pork with a variety of vegetables and fruits such as potatoes, raisins, carrots and chilies. It is eaten with bread called bolillo. Pozole is a soup with a salsa base. It can be white, red or green, corn, meat that can be either pork or chicken, and it is accompanied with antojitos like tostadas, tacos and tamales. The resort area is divided into three parts. The north end of the bay and beyond is the traditional area, which encompasses the area from Park Papagao through the Socalo and onto the beaches of Cala and Calatu. The main part of the bay known as Zona Dorada, Golden Zone in Spanish, where the famous in the mid-20th century vacationed. And the south end Diamante, Diamond in Spanish, which is dominated by newer luxury high-rise hotels and condominiums. The name Acapulco comes from Nahuatl language Acapulco, and means where the reeds were destroyed or washed away. The de Juárez was added to the official name in 1885 to honor Benito Juárez, former president of Mexico, 1806-1872. The seal for the city shows broken reeds or cane. The island and municipality of Capal, in the Philippines, derives its name from Acapulco. Capal was the western end of the Trans-Pacific sailing route from Acapulco to what was then a Spanish colony.
The Alhandiga de Granaditas is an old grain storage building in Guanajuato City, Mexico. This historic building was created to replace an old granary near the city's river. The name translates roughly from both Arabic and Spanish as grain market or warehouse. Its construction lasted from 1798 to 1809, by orders of Juan Antonio de Riana y Barcina, a Spaniard who was the quartermaster of the city during the Viceroyalty of New Spain. The building received World Heritage listing as part of the historic town of Guanajuato in 1988. The Alhandiga is an example of neoclassical ideas. The original design was drafted in 1796 by José Alejandro Durán y Villaseñor, who was the master of public works. José de Maza y Aviles modified the plans later. It measures 72 by 68 meters, with a height of 23 meters, and occupies an area of 4,828 square meters. It is constructed on the side of a hill and two of its sides are surrounded by elevations. There are no ornamental facets on the exterior, except for a few windows at the top of each storage room. It has cornices built in a Doric style, constructed with two types of regional stone, reddish and greenish. This gives it a curious appearance, resembling a stronghold or a castle, which it has come to be called by the people of Guanajuato. In the interior, there is a porch that leads to a spacious central patio. The porch contains Tuscan columns and adornments. There are two staircases that lead to the upper floor. The Alhandiga has only two access doors, a small one facing the east, adorned by two columns, and a large door of the same basic style, facing the north. The edifice was used for the buying and selling of wheat, corn, and other grains. Prior to the Mexican independence from Spain, it was used as a warehouse, military barracks, and prison. Currently it serves as a regional museum. Attached to one side of the alhandiga is a large plaza with a set of wide steps that rise to meet the edge of the building. During the annual International Cervantino Festival, this space is converted into a large open-air auditorium for live performances. The shows, often music and dance by groups of worldwide acclaim, are free to the general public, with reserved seats directly below the stage. Inside of the museum are exhibits and art honoring heroes of the independence. Bonampak is an ancient Maya archaeological site in the Mexican state of Chiapas. The site is approximately 30 kilometers south of the larger site of Yaxcolan, under which Bonampak was a dependency, and the border with Guatemala. While the site is not overly impressive in terms of spatial or architectural size, American archaeologist, epigrapher, and Mayanist scholar Sylvanus Morley once stated that Bonampak was fourth-rate in terms of size and political importance. It is well known for the murals located within the three-roomed structure 1, the Temple of the Murals. The construction of the site's structures dates to the late Classic period. In addition to being among the best-preserved Maya murals, the Bonampak murals are noteworthy for debunking early assumptions that the Maya were a peaceful culture of mystics, a position long held and argued for by the well-known early Mesoamerican archaeologist, ethnohistorian and epigrapher from the Carnegie Institute of Washington, Sir John Eric Sidney Thompson, as the murals clearly depict war and human sacrifice. The site, lying close to a tributary of the Usumacinta River, was first seen by non-Mayans in 1946. Precisely who was first is a matter of speculation, but it was either by two American travelers, Herman Charles, Carlos, Frey and John Bourne, or photographer, explorer Giles Healy. The Americans were led to the ruins by the local Lacandon Maya who still visited the site to pray in the ancient temples. Giles Healy was the first to be shown the huge paintings covering the walls of one of the structure's three rooms. The paintings show the story of a single battle and its victorious outcome. Bird Jaguar in the early 5th century fought against Kinichdat Buscali in Yaxcolan, and lost his freedom. Other nobles were captured in a later war against Nahui Jaguar I. In 514, Nahui Jaguar I was himself taken captive by ruler C of Piedras Negras, giving Bonampak some respite, but after 526, his successor Kinichdat Buscali II attacked Bonampak again and captured more lords. Bonampak by 600 CE had become a satellite of Yaxcolan. In that time, the Ajual of Yaxcolan installed Yajah Chanlawana as lord in Bonampak. Subsequent Ajawab reconstructed the site to orient toward the metropolis. See 790 CE, Yaxcolan's King Shield Jaguar III oversaw the installation of Chanlawan II, and hired Yaxcolano artisans to commemorate it in structure I's murals. Bonampak collapsed with Yaxcolan in the 9th century.
Calakmul is a Maya archaeological site in the Mexican state of Campeche, deep in the jungles of the Greater Payten Basin region. It is 35 kilometers from the Guatemalan border. Calakmul was one of the largest and most powerful ancient cities ever uncovered in the Maya lowlands. Calakmul was a major Maya power within the northern Payten Basin region of the Yucatan Peninsula of southern Mexico. Calakmul administered a large domain marked by the extensive distribution of their emblem glyph of the snake head sign, to be Redkin. Calakmul was the seat of what has been dubbed the Kingdom of the Snake or Snake Kingdom. This snake kingdom reigned during most of the Classic period. Calakmul itself is estimated to have had a population of 50,000 people and had governance, at times, over places as far away as 150 kilometers. There are 6,750 ancient structures identified at Calakmul, the largest of which is the Great Pyramid at the site. Structure 2 is over 45 meters high, making it one of the tallest of the Maya pyramids. Four tombs have been located within the pyramid. Like many temples or pyramids within Mesoamerica, the pyramid at Calakmul increased in size by building upon the existing temple to reach its current size. The size of the central monumental architecture is approximately 2 square kilometers, and the whole of the site, mostly covered with dense residential structures, is about 20 square kilometers. The site is surrounded by an extensive network of canals and reservoirs. There are 5 major reservoirs, including the largest example in the Maya world, measuring 242 by 212 meters. This reservoir is filled by a small seasonal river during the rainy season and continues to hold enough water for it to be used by archaeologists in modern times. 13 reservoirs have been identified at Calakmul. The combined capacity of all the reservoirs is estimated at over 200 million liters. Throughout the Classic period, Calakmul maintained an intense rivalry with the major city of Tikal to the south, and the political maneuverings of these two cities have been likened to a struggle between two Maya superpowers. Rediscovered from the air by biologist Cyrus L. Lundell of the Mexican Exploitation Chicle Company on December 29, 1931, the find was reported to Sylvanus G. Morley of the Carnegie Institute at Chicansa in March 1932.
The Camino Real de Tierra Adentro, Spanish for Royal Road of the Interior Land, was a 2,560-kilometer long trade route between Mexico City and San Juan Pueblo, New Mexico, from 1598 to 1882. In 2010, 55 sites and 5 existing World Heritage sites along the Mexican section of the route became an entry on the UNESCO World Heritage List. Those sites include historic cities, towns, bridges, haciendas and other monuments along the 1,400 kilometers route between the historic center of Mexico City, Independent World Heritage Site, and the town of Vale de Allende, Chihuahua. The 404-mile, 646-kilometer section of the route within the United States was proclaimed as a part of the National Historic Trail System on October 13, 2000. El Camino Real de Tierra Adentro National Historic Trail is overseen by both the National Park Service and the U.S. Bureau of Land Management with aid from El Camino Real de Tierra Adentro Trail Associates, also known as CARTA. A portion of the trail near San Acacia, New Mexico was listed on the National Register of Historic Places in 2014. The trail was used for trade among native tribes since the earliest of times. In 1598, Olmec followed the trail while leading a group of settlers north during the era of Spanish conquest. The duration of the trip from the Rio Grande to the San Juan Pueblo was said to take, by wagon and by foot, approximately 6 months, including 2 to 3 weeks of rest throughout the trip. According to journals kept by settlers, they used common animals found along the trail to add to the food they brought along. The trail greatly improved trade among Spanish villages and helped the Spanish conquistadors spread Christianity throughout the conquered lands. The trail was used from 1598 through 1881 when the railroad replaced the need for wagons. Eventually, railroads replaced trotted trails, and over time the trail and evidence of it faded from sight and memory. The changes that the railways brought made trade along El Camino much easier and in some cases made travel quite luxurious and exciting.
Cancun is a city in southeastern Mexico on the northeast coast of the Yucatan Peninsula in the Mexican state of Quintana Roo. It is an important tourist destination in Mexico and the seat of the municipality of Benito Juárez. The city is on the Caribbean Sea, and is one of Mexico's easternmost points. Cancun is just north of Mexico's Caribbean Coast Resort band known as the Riviera Maya. In older English language documents, the city's name is sometimes spelled Cancun, an attempt to convey the sound of the name. Apart from the island tourist zone, part of the world's second longest coral reef, the Mexican residential section of the city, the downtown part of which is known as El Centro, follows a master plan that consists of supermanzanas, superblocks, giant trapezoids with a central, open, non-residential area cut in by U-shaped residential streets. These open centers usually have walkways and sidewalks around a central garden park, or football fields, or a library, etc., which make the mainland Mexican Cancun bicycle friendly. the residential roads of central or mainland Cancun, U-shaped and cul-de-sacs, insulate housing from the noise and congestion of the main flow of traffic. Mainland Cancun has a central market that resembles an outlet mall, colorful buildings on a pedestrian city block. Avenue Tulum is the main north-south artery, connecting downtown to the airport, which is some 30 kilometers south of downtown. Tulum is bisected by Avenue Coba. East of Avenue Tulum, Coba becomes Avenue Kukulkan, which serves as the primary road through the seven-shaped hotel zone. Avenue Tulum ends on the north side at Avenue Paseo José López Portillo, which connects to the main highway west to Chichen Itza and Mérida. Less expensive developments are composed almost entirely of identical one- or two-story small row houses, sometimes built around interior plazas or four-story apartment blocks. Until recently, most mainland buildings were four stories or shorter. Since 2005, there has been an influx of condominium and luxury retail and office space concentrated along Avenue Panampac. Cancun's mainland or downtown area has diverged from the original plan. Development is scattered around the city. The remaining undeveloped beach and lagoon front areas outside the hotel zone are now under varying stages of development, in Punta Sam and Puerto Juarez to the north, continuing along Panampac and south toward the airport along Boulevard Donaldo Colosio.
Chichen Itza was a large pre-Columbian city built by the Maya people of the Terminal Classic period. The archaeological site is located in Tinan Municipality, Yucatan State, Mexico. Chichen Itza was a major focal point in the northern Maya lowlands from the late Classic through the Terminal Classic and into the early portion of the post-Classic period. The site exhibits a multitude of architectural styles, reminiscent of styles seen in central Mexico and of the Puuc and Chin styles of the northern Maya lowlands. The presence of central Mexican styles was once thought to have been representative of direct migration or even conquest from central Mexico, but most contemporary interpretations view the presence of these non-Maya styles more as the result of cultural diffusion. Chichen Itza was one of the largest Maya cities, and it was likely to have been one of the mythical great cities, or Tolans, referred to in later Mesoamerican literature. The city may have had the most diverse population in the Maya world, a factor that could have contributed to the variety of architectural styles at the site. The ruins of Chichen Itza are federal property, and the site's stewardship is maintained by Mexico's Instituto Nacional de Antropología y Historia, National Institute of Anthropology and History. Chichen Itza was one of the largest Maya cities, with the relatively densely clustered architecture of the site core covering an area of at least 5 square kilometers. Smaller-scale residential architecture extends for an unknown distance beyond this. The city was built upon broken terrain, which was artificially leveled in order to build the major architectural groups, with the greatest effort being expended in the leveling of the areas for the Castillo Pyramid, and the Las Munges, Osorio and Main Southwest groups. The site contains many fine stone buildings in various states of preservation, and many have been restored. The buildings were connected by a dense network of paved causeways, called sacbeob. Archaeologists have identified over 80 sacbeob crisscrossing the site, and extending in all directions from the city. Many of these stone buildings were originally painted in red, green, blue and purple colors. Pigments were chosen according to what was most easily available in the area. The site must be imagined as a colorful one, not like it is today. Just like Gothic cathedrals in Europe, colors provided a greater sense of completeness and contributed greatly to the symbolic impact of the buildings.
Copper Canyon is a group of canyons consisting of 6 distinct canyons in the Sierra Madre Occidental in the southwestern part of the state of Chihuahua in northwestern Mexico. The canyons were formed by 6 rivers that drain the western side of the Sierra Tarahumara, a part of the Sierra Madre Occidental. All 6 rivers merge into the Rio Fuerte and empty into the Gulf of California. The walls of the canyon are a copper, green color, which is where the name originates. The Sierra Tarahumara Occidental region contains some 23 species of pine and 200 species of oak trees. Mexican Douglas fir, Pseudotsuga lindleyana, trees cover the high plateaus in altitudes over 8,000 feet, 2,400 meters, but due to deforestation in the area, many species of wildlife are endangered. Cougars live in the remotest of regions and are rarely seen. After the summer rainy season, these upper regions blossom with wildflowers until October. From 4,000 to 8,000 feet, 1,200 to 2,400 meters, oak trees grow in the huge forests as well as the more shade-tolerant types of trees. In the fall, the forests become brilliant with color from Andean alder and poplar trees. Brushwood and scrubby trees grow on the canyon slopes, which can accommodate the dry season. Huge fig and palm trees thrive at the bottom where water is plentiful and the climate is tropical. There are many other ways to explore Copper Canyon, such as hiking, biking, driving or horseback riding. The most popular way is by train, as the Ferrocarril Chihuahua-Pachifico-Warchape runs along the main canyon called Canyon Reek, between Chihuahua and Las Moches, and the Gulf of California. The Chihuahua-Pachifico began in the late 19th century. The revolution, lack of funding, and the overall difficulty of building a railroad over such terrain hindered its completion until 1961. The railroad comprises 405 miles of rails with 39 bridges and 86 tunnels. The total trip takes approximately 15 hours and passes through towns, as well as the towering cliffs of the canyons. Along the railway, many Tarahumarans lay out their food, crafts and other wares for sale. Mexico established the Parque Nacional Barranca del Cobre, Copper Canyon National Park, to showcase this remote area. The park is located in the municipalities of Batopolis, Bocoina, Guacachi, and Reek. The Bosses Chick Falls National Park around the Bosses Chick Falls is located within the canyon area.
Cozumel is an island and municipality in the Caribbean Sea off the eastern coast of Mexico's Yucatan Peninsula, opposite Playa del Carmen, and close to the Yucatan Channel. The municipality is part of the state of Quintana Roo, Mexico. The economy of Cozumel is based on tourism. There are a number of visitors to the island's balnearios, scuba diving, and snorkeling. The main town on the island is San Miguel de Cozumel. The island is located in the Caribbean Sea along the eastern side of the Yucatan Peninsula, about 82 kilometers south of Cancun, and 19 kilometers from the mainland. The island is about 48 kilometers long and 16 kilometers wide, with a total area of 477.961 square kilometers. It is Mexico's largest Caribbean island, largest permanently inhabited island, and Mexico's third largest island, following Tiburon Island and Isla Angel de la Guarda. The island is covered with mangrove forest, which has many endemic animal species. Cozumel is a flat island based on limestone, resulting in a karst topography. The highest natural point on the island is less than 15 meters above sea level. The cenotes are deep water-filled sinkholes formed by water percolating through the soft limestone soil for thousands of years. Cozumel cenotes are restricted to qualified cave divers with appropriate credentials. Tourism, diving and charter fishing comprise the majority of the island's economy. There are more than 300 restaurants on the island and many hotels, some of which run dive operations, have swimming pools, private docks, and multiple dining facilities. Other water activities include parasailing, kitesurfing, and a tourist submarine. There are also two dolphinariums. At the cruise ship docks, there are several square blocks of stores selling Cuban cigars, jewelry, t-shirts, tequila, and a large variety of inexpensive souvenirs. San Miguel is home to many restaurants with a huge variety of different cuisines, along with several discotheques, bars, cinemas, and outdoor stages. The main plaza is surrounded by shops. In the middle of the plaza is a fixed stage, where Cozumelanos and tourists celebrate every Sunday evening with music and dancing. All food and manufactured supplies are shipped to the island. Water is provided by three different desalination facilities located on the island.
Campeche is one of the 31 states which, with the federal district, comprise the 32 federal entities of Mexico. Located in southeast Mexico, it is bordered by the states of Tabasco to the southwest, Yucatan to the northeast, and Quintana Roo to the east. To the southeast by the Orange Walk District of Belize, and by the Payton Department of Guatemala to the south. It has a coastline to the west with the Gulf of Mexico. The state capital, also called Campeche, was declared a World Heritage Site in 1997. Much of Campeche's territory is filled with various archaeological sites, almost all of which are Mayan. These sites are far less known and visited than sites to the east such as Chichen Itza, Uxmal and Tulum. An early important site is Edzna, located near the city of Campeche in a region known as Los Chines. It was one of the most important ceremonial centers in the pre-classic Maya period, 300 to 900 CE. The largest archaeological site in the state is Calakmul, which means twin heaps in Maya. It is located in the Payton region built in the late classic period, 500 to 900 CE. Calakmul is estimated to have been populated around 1000 BCE with its height at around 600. In 695 CE, Calakmul was conquered by Tikal and the city fell into decline. While most sites are in the interior rainforest of the state, there are 55 archaeological sites on the coast alone, mostly remnants of small villages. The Isla de Gina is one of the best preserved archaeological sites in the state because of its location on an island on the coast, surrounded by estuaries and mangroves. Campeche is one of the least known and unrated colonial cities in Mexico, mostly bypassed by those visiting more famous destinations in the Yucatan Peninsula. The city's historic buildings are protected by decree to keep them from being destroyed or altered by the growth of the city. Campeche was one of the most important ports in New Spain. Notable museums in the state include the Del Carmen Archaeological Museum, the Museo de las Estelas Mayas in Ciudad del Carmen and the Camino Real Archaeological Museum in Hexalchicán. The Museo Fuerte de San Miguel is located on one of the Campeche's old forts. The museum is dedicated to the state's history. Opened in 2000, it is the newest and most modern of Campeche's museums.